good morning, and please be seated. And welcome to our worship service today, our Christmas musicale. A warm welcome extended to everybody here today, especially those who might be visiting for the first time or come back from an absence. Your presence greatly enriches us, and we welcome you here today. And also like to say a welcome to everybody who might be following us today on our Facebook live stream too. And after the service, everybody is invited to come upstairs, if you wish, for a time of coffee and tea and snacks to continue further celebrate this day. As we begin our time, I'd like to say a thank you to everybody who's involved today. Thank you to our guest musicians, the Southern Alberta Trombone Collective, flautist Naomi Powell and vocalist Camille Rogers. Thank you to the McKillop musicians, Joan Rogers and the McKillop Handbell Choir, Marilyn and John Paul and Ken and the members of the Senior Choir. They've enjoyed working together to offer this musical service this morning. And thanks to all the scripture readers and prayer readers today, Austin Fennell, Doreen Brazier, Marie Fitzpatrick, Barbara Hamm, Tammy Bolstead, Mary Fulton Schroeder, and Joyce Weber. The hymns today will not be announced, so please follow along in your bulletin, or you can just follow along the screen. The children that are present, if they wish, are invited to go to the back of the church to meet Joy. Are you back there, Joy? She's waving away. To go to the children's program following the lighting of the Advent candles. And also, I ask you not to applaud until the end of the service, if of all possible, but let this music lift your hearts and your souls into the spirit of this season. And to the Senior Choir dedicates their music in this service in loving memory of Judy Forbes, who sang faithfully and joyfully for us for many years before her sudden passing this past May. They and we miss Judy and her wonderful smile and laughter. Also during this season, it's a time of giving, and there's many ways to give if you wish, not just here at McKillop, but in our community. I know we're continuing to collect for our Bakeless Bake Sale, our Gift for Visions, our Midden Tree, and gifts for Join Us at the Table event that's coming up too. And if you want church council is inviting to hear from you as we compile our annual report for next year. What do you love and celebrate about McKillop this year? We're compiling stories, personal quotes, and significant events that are 99 words or less. And there's information in the bulletin if you'd like to help with that. And then finally, we have three Christmas Eve services coming up in a few days. Our 4 o'clock children's service, which is 35 minutes of controlled chaos with a children's story and craft. It's a fun time for children. It's specifically designed for children or children at heart. Our 7 p.m. Family service, then a 9 p.m. quieter service with communion at 9 o'clock. And as always, there's lots of information in our bulletin about what's coming up in 2020. It's hard to believe we're talking about that. And I invite you to read it at your leisure. And as we join together at McKillop, we always, each and every Sunday, affirm each other. Whoever we are and however we identify ourselves, this is a place for us to be and to celebrate everything that we are. I invite you now to join together in our call to worship, which is on our screen. I invite you to read the bold. Glory to God in the highest.
And hope to every discouraged heart.
Glory to God in the highest.
And peace to every conflicted soul and place in our world.
Glory to God in the highest.
And joy.
Glory to God in the highest.
And love to everyone, so they may find the presence of Christ within them and around them, the light of the world.
Amen.
Well, good morning. Today we relight three candles representing hope and peace and joy. Today we light the fourth candle, the candle of love. With this flame we signify the love of God that surrounds us and fills us at all times, but that we recognize in a special way in the Christmas story. There is no greater power than love. It is stronger than rulers and empires, stronger than grief or despair, stronger even than death. We love because God loves us.
In a world where consumption and materialism rule, profit is more important than people or the environment, and there is no room for the mystery and surprise, we call upon you, God of love and compassion, to come and help us find the deeper meaning of Christmas again, to help us awaken to love within us and to be the Christ love that heals and renews. Now we light the candle of love.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who loves each one of us, we thank you for revealing your love for us through Jesus. We thank you for his birth. You have sent him among us, the Savior of the world, and we are grateful that he is a king, unlike all other kings of this world. We offer to you our joyful music, and with it, our praise to you. Great is our God. Inspire us, we pray, to be generous to those in need. And help us, we pray, your church to be faithful and to be a light in the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Our first reading this morning is taken from Mark 1, verses 1 to 3. The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight.'"
Thank you. Isaiah 11, 1 to 3a and 10. A shoot shall come out from the stock of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. On that day, the root of Jesse shall stand as a signal to all peoples. The nations shall inquire of him, and his dwelling shall be glorious.
Thank you. Thank you.
2, verses 8 to 14. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
Thank you. this time of year, when the list of things that need doing may seem endless as we prepare for festive gatherings, or when we may feel the strain of life's changes and challenges, let us bring to you our offering, including our money as well as gifts of time and talent and hearts and minds. Help us to feel deep into our core that each act of kindness, friendly smile, hug shared, card sent, and carol sung is a reflection of your infinite love. Let our offering be a light in the dark places and a beacon of hope and love in a hurting world. In your Son's name, Jesus, we pray. Amen.
My scripture is also from Luke 2, verses 4 to 7. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth, laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you. continuing from Luke, verses 15 to 20. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
What I see,
do you see what I see?
given us this gift today. You have blessed us in so many ways. This Christmas, we wish for you light to crumple up the darkness. This Christmas, we wish for you love to bind us to one another. This Christmas, we wish to you peace in our hearts and families and world. This Christmas, we wish to you starlight to show you your journey. This Christmas, we wish to you hope to hear God's promise that God will always be with you. This Christmas, we wish to you Christ be born anew in each one of us so all of life is cherished in its dignity. So go from here to life in all its abundance with the blessing of God Almighty, Christ our light, in the presence of the Holy Spirit. Amen.